Okay, thank you again for the invitation, because this morning, especially this morning, I've learned a lot, especially with Thiru and Carla, regarding the SCR. I've learned a lot, thank you. But I have a question for you. Do you really want to live for the next 10 years into this box, this black box? I propose you to travel with me outside of the box, looking for another option. I don't know if in the next 10 years I will be still there, and which one between the Lac d'Orsay or the SCR will be a survivor. But this is what I do. First of all, you have to understand what is the triangular space. And you can see on the picture that the inferior border of the teres minor is a part of the triangular space. The long head of the triceps is the point, and it's vertical. As you can see, the triceps is vertical. The teres minor is horizontal. And we have the teres major and the Lac d'Orsay just under. So sorry for mouse. Okay, so now we are on the left shoulder, and you can see that we are on the right, there is the deltoid, and on the left, this is the teres minor. You go through, you open the aponevrosis, and then you will find a muscle. So which is this muscle? Sometimes it's difficult to be sure, and it's either the Lac d'Orsay or the teres major, but the goal is to find the vertical fibers of the long head of the tricep. This is the key to success to this dissection. Take care, because if you see some vessels or some nerve, that means you are too lateral, you are into the quadrilateral space, and this is a very bad idea. So this is a muscle, you can see, it seems very big, so you continue the dissection, the less dangerous it is, and then you go a little lateral, and you open, and then you can see something which is vertical. And what is vertical on the left of your screen, which is vertical, is the long head of the triceps. You continue the dissection, but still stay medial from the long head of the triceps, because this is the safe area. So that means inside, at the deep part of this video, you see the teres major and the latissimus dorsi. This is the triceps on the left, and you can see now after this dissection the teres major, which is horizontal on the top. You continue this dissection between the triceps on the left and the teres minor, which is horizontal, and you can see this triangular space. So the teres minor, the vertical part of the long head triceps, and you can see here inside, you can see the teres major and the Lac d'Orsay. Then you try to go up in this area, so medial from the long head of the triceps, because it is the way, it is the triangular space, and this is, it's very important to enlarge, to have a nice dissection of this area, because you need some space to go. So the second step is how to harvest the tendon. So sorry, but we are now on the right shoulder, the first one was the left shoulder. And because it's very difficult to have a perfect movies from the very beginning to the end. So this is the distal edge of the Lac d'Orsay, you can see. And I use a very simple system. I loop my tendon with a Krakow suture, and I make a triple Krakow suture. And this is the distal edge of the tendon. As you know, and as said Philippe, I try to put it flat onto the footprint, and not, I do not tuberize it because of a high risk of failure. So when the tendon is flat, you have a high rate of healing. Then you cut the tendon from the humerus, and you can see the Lac d'Orsay will be off, will be up, and just under you have the teres major. So you have two options. Either you take only the Lac d'Orsay, or you take both. And for many months now, I prefer to take both, just because it's easier, and we can discuss later, but I think it's stronger, and probably my results are better now.
So can you just talk about the portals?
Yes, I would like to stop, or I continue. My portals. I am, when you make a tenodesis of a biceps in two its grooves, like I've shown 2 days ago, it's exactly the same portal. So you just take a look, you see the PEC major, we are under the PEC major, and you can see on the left, you can see the transistors and the subscap. So you see the white is the Lat Dorsey, the red is the teres major, and you can see how bulky is the teres major. And try to, you can see here the needle, try the subscap just over, and you push here, and okay, this is my second triple Krakow suture. So we have the green one at the distal edge of the Lat Dorsey, and we have the blue one at the upper part of the Lat Dorsey, both the Lat Dorsey and the teres major. Then you pull up this double transfer, and you have to release, and this is the teres major, and you have to go as deep as possible till you see the long head of the triceps. So you remember the long head of the tricep is the key to the dissection, because we have to go medial from the long head of the triceps to go into the triangular space. So now we are, of course, anterior at the anterior part of the shoulder. This is the bicep, the long head of the triceps, which is just up here now. Okay, and this is the radial nerve. So this is the left shoulder again. So sorry for that. Maybe I have to make better the next time. But you can see the radial nerve, which gives some branches to the long head of the triceps. The muscle here is the long head of the triceps. You see, it's vertical, and in fact, you have to detach the Lat Dorsey and the teres major from the long head of the triceps. You have to go medially. Medially from the long head of the triceps, you have no risk, there is no vessel there. And then you release all this muscle belly, this is the Lat Dorsey, and you continue on the right. You can see we are going to the head on the top. And you have to take very care now, because the higher you go close to the subscap, the closer the axillary nerve will be. So take very care, because you have to see and to control everything, but okay. You push up the double transfer, and you continue to release, and this is the teres major. And you can see on the right, we have here the white, which is covered, this is the axillary nerve. So we have the double transfer here, and then remember, I've put a loop from the posterior part of the shoulder, and look at, we are now medial from the head of the triceps, and you have to enlarge and to release everything, because this double transfer will go in, and as it's very bulky, you can have some impingement. So this is the most demanding step, and I have to confess that it was a long time for me to understand what was really the triangular space behind in the posterior part, posterior view, and the anterior view. And it's more demanding, of course, because sometimes you have a left shoulder, sometimes a right shoulder, and you have to learn something in your head. But in fact, the anatomy is always the same, and I always say that it's easier than when you pull back and you continue to release as distal as possible. And I don't do like Laurent Lafosse, I don't do any axillary incision, because I think it's totally useless, because I use a very long vapor, and it's not a problem for that. And the goal, again, is not to go over the top. The goal is to go just posterior onto the footprint of the infraspinatus. Again, you can see the radial nerve. And you continue, and I wanted to show you this right shoulder. We are, because it is again the triangular space, so you can make the gymnastic in your head with me. And it's very important to see the axillary nerve, which and the vessels, and you can see it's vertical, and it is the quadrilateral space. So take care about that. Go medial from the long head of the triceps, and take very, very care when you release the upper part of this double transfer, because it's hazardous, of course. But when you see, there is no risk at all. And again, you have your loop from the back to the anterior part. And again, I think what is very important is to release as much as possible all this space, this triangular space, because all your double transfer will be pulled up, go through this space, and then you pull back, and you continue the release. And if you continue this release, you are able to see, if you want, the cannula. So this is the distal part of the radial nerve, the distal part of the release. because sometimes you have some connection with the long-haired triceps. And again, now we are into the triangular space, and if you continue the release, because this view is very nice, you can see your posterior cannula. That means you are into the posterior part of the shoulder. You will see the cannula, and you can see that the transfer will be possible. You see the cannula from the back is into the front now, and it is large enough to pull back your double transfer. Again, it's really easier to take both. So now the last step, it is the posterior fixation. So I say the posterior fixation and not the postero superior for two reasons, because we think that the goal is to rebalance the shoulder, not to feel a defect, in fact. And you can see here to the back the double transfer coming up. Remember that we have both the lat dorsi and the teres major. The teres major is in fact short and it cannot go over the top. So I just fix very easily with two anchors flat onto the footprint, and I pull in the neutral position, and I don't look to have too high a tension. So this could be debatable because I still have a significant defect on the superior part of the shoulder. So I think the philosophy is totally different than the SCR, because the SCR, you feel the defect, in fact, even if you have a central, you can center the head. In that situation, you don't feel anything, you just rebalance the shoulder, and you fix the double transfer at the posterior part of the footprint. And you will see here, so you will see here how is the transfer and the direction. This is for Bassem, but I put my scope posteriorly. The direction is very close to the direction of the teres minor. And maybe this is one of the reasons, if you want to recreate the ER2, the lat dorsi and the teres major is better than the lower trapezius. But if you want to recreate the ER1, of course, the infraspinatus seems better. Okay, thank you very much.